Welcome to Inside the Taubman Approach podcast. I'm your host, Benjamin Harding. This new podcast is an inside look at the power of the Taubman Approach, an approach to working with playing-related problems such as discomfort, tension, pain, and injuries. Through firsthand experiences and discussions with some of the premier teachers of this approach, we'll be sharing how pianists at various stages of learning the piano have benefited and grown through applying the Taubman Approach. Sponsored by the Golandsky Institute. The Golandsky Institute is on a mission to provide cutting-edge instruction to pianists based on the groundbreaking work of Dorothy Taubman. If you're interested in learning more about the Taubman Approach, be sure to check out the show notes of this episode and follow links to sign up for our newsletter, to stay up to date with all that the Institute offers, including their premier subscription service that allows you to take lessons on the Taubman Approach from anywhere. Let's get into today's episode. Today's episode is really inspiring. In a previous episode, we mentioned that the Taubman Approach is for everyone. For example, if you are an older adult that played the piano when you were younger and want to begin to get back into playing the piano, the Taubman Approach really is the best way that you can accomplish that. Today's episode is with Nathan Kaplan. He goes through the ups and downs of learning the Taubman Approach as an adult learner. Nathan is a retired public school teacher in the New York City public school system, where he taught music and even played professionally. Nathan came to the Taubman Approach at the age of 65, wanting to play the piano at a higher level. At first, Nathan's experience in learning the work was a difficult one, but through the patience and perseverance of both John Bloomfield and Nathan, his playing has totally been transformed. Nathan is an inspiration. In this episode, he shows that through the Taubman Approach, the sky is the limit for what can be achieved. Nathan Kaplan, welcome to Inside the Taubman Approach.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Nathan, we're recording this podcast in different locations. Where are you coming from today?
I live in Manhattan, New York, Midtown area, so that's where I am.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So you live and work there as
a professor? I'm actually retired.
Really?
Yeah. So yeah, I'm actually, I don't look it, but I'm actually 73 years old. And
amazing, Nathan.
Most people do a double take when they hear that. They said, really? It's, you know, a combination of good things. So I'm very happy, you know, and I'm reasonably good health. So, you know, that's so important for anything that you want to do.
So professionally, what did you retire from?
I was a music teacher in the New York City Department of Education. And I've been retired for quite a while. So
wow. You are our hero for investing in these young ones all those many years. Wow, that is a phenomenal privilege and honor, and what an amazing work you had to do in New York City.
Yeah, yeah. It was a lot of challenges, let me tell you. Different schools, different neighborhoods, a lot of politics. And at the end of the day, the important thing was to try to impart something of value to kids and hopefully, you know, give them something that they could, you know, improve their lives or better their lives, some kind of, you know, in this case, you know, a love for music, you know. So that was my goal.
So give us your kind of history with music, maybe from an early age. How did your love of music develop?
Well, basically, my father loved classical music, and he had a pretty good record collection, and he would put these long playing records on, and I would dance all up and down the living room, 3 years old, you know, and I grew up learning all this wonderful stuff. And, I just took to, classical music, right away. I mean, I listened to other kinds of music as well, but, that was my mainstay. And actually I did when I was about 30 years ago, my God, I can't believe it's so long ago. I did a brief foray into jazz and, I enjoyed it, but then I went back to classical. So, that's basically it. And then my parents, who were, just wonderful, and very giving and very, dedicated, they didn't spare anything for my musical education. So, I went to a chamber music school in the summers, took lessons, did the whole thing. So it was really, really, really fortunate because there are many people with talent who don't get that opportunity. So I was really, really fortunate.
Wow. This is wonderful. And yeah, our families, it really takes a village to educate us as musicians, really. I'm so grateful for my parents, for their sacrifices. You're grateful for your parents and their sacrifices to bring us to a place where we can enjoy music and love music and share our love of music. So, fast forward through your education, you're working in the New York public school system. How did you come about the Taubman approach?
Okay, well, I have a friend who's a little bit younger than I am, but he follows musicians. He just has this thing for, he just loves musicians. Plays a little bit here and there, a few instruments, but he just absolutely loves musicians. And he told me about Taubman. And I guess I went to a workshop in the city, in New York City. This must have been 2016. And,
okay.
And that was my first experience with it.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So
summer symposium.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, which is, I'm kind of like, do I want to do this? And I said, yes, because what was happening was I had retired in a long time ago, 2006, from my teaching career. And I basically, was practicing every day at the piano, playing pieces that no matter how much I practiced them, they didn't get better. And I was fortunate not to have any injuries. I guess I didn't practice that much or else I would have had injuries. But, I was so frustrating. So, so frustrating. The same passages day after day. They just wouldn't get faster. They wouldn't feel comfortable. It was especially after I switched back from jazz to classical. Mm. And it was so frustrating.
Yeah.
Yeah, really, really stymied.
And so you come across the Taubman approach in 2016. Fast forward just a little bit, and how did you come in contact with your current teacher in the Taubman approach?
Okay, so I took the summer symposium, and I met the faculty, including John Bloomfield, who I've been studying with, and at the very beginning, at the end of the symposium, I remember going to this party, and they were all standing around me, and looking at me, and expecting me to say yes, I want to join, I want to start Taubman, and I was very resistant. I didn't want to do it because something that you've done your whole life a certain way. And, I'd played professionally in certain venues.
Yeah.
And, I consider myself, I know how to play, and the whole thing with the Taubman was with rotation and then using your body instead of just your fingers. And that whole thing, I don't want to do this. This doesn't make any sense. It's, then I really, really thought about it. And, I finally, met up with John and I started lessons with him. And I was 65 years of age, almost 66 actually. And, I remember it very vividly. I can go into more detail if you want with the lessons and,
Well, yeah, we definitely want to hear about sort of first impressions for sure. I mean, so you're a retired gentleman. You go to the symposium. You're a little skeptical, but in the background is sort of this frustration,
right?
In terms of learning pieces quickly or in a facile way,
right?
And so you go to your first lesson to John. What was that like? What was that like? Describe.
Well, I presented a piece of music that I wanted to play. It was a Chopin scherzo, and you know, in Taubman they have something called a retraining, where you can actually it's very, very flexible. But evidently, I mean, you can take part of it and you can study with a teacher, and or you can go through a retraining with a teacher. So I guess we both came to the conclusion that I needed retraining. So, you know, retraining is like, you know, and that was really, really daunting. So after the first lesson or so, we got rid of the Chopin scherzo, and I worked for 9 months, I kid you not, 9 months on two scales, hands separately. I didn't even play the hands together. So can you imagine after having, you know, spent my lifetime in music, you know, playing professionally and, you know, I know how to play and how to do this and blah, 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 blah. And then suddenly, you know, having to go back to square one, you know, like I was 6 years old, and learn how to do scales properly. And I actually, I had a joke. I made a joke about it. I was in labor for 9 months with two scales, and I gave birth to a Bach invention. That's what it felt like, you know, wow, had this baby now. I actually can do a Bach invention. I mean, that's how long it took me. It didn't, you know, it wasn't instant. It wasn't an instant process. And I have to say that, you know, John is so amazing. There are so many times, especially during the first year and beyond, where I really wanted to give up. You know, I didn't tell him that, but boy, did I feel that way after the lessons. And it wasn't John at all. It was me. It was just, it was so difficult. And so, you know, sometimes felt humiliating, you know. It was just so hard, but I made it. I got through it. And I got to the point where I could actually study this Bach invention. And then from then on, I was able to progress more quickly because I had this foundation, you know.
That's phenomenal. And, you know, it just speaks to the fact that this is real work. This is not a gimmick. It comes for people in this learning process differently, to each his own, so to speak. I mean, individuals, it lands on people in different ways, but what courage for you to stick with it for nine full months. Yeah, that must have been really, really difficult. And, so fast forward to now, tell us what you're playing now and tell us sort of how the learning process has been changed for you in the Taubman approach.
Yeah, it's very, very different. My playing is different and my approach to practicing is different because, you know, when I used to practice before the Taubman approach, it was like for years and years, maybe I'll practice a passage or a measure or whatever, you know, umpteen times, and maybe it'll get better. And sometimes it did get better, but, you know, as I said, there was a level, especially with, see, I always wanted to play more advanced literature. You know, Liszt and stuff like that, more difficult piano literature. And I could never do it. It was just, and I was so frustrated all that time. So, sorry, where was I? So, what happened was,
You're practicing change.
Yeah, I was playing, you know, I was practicing these passages, you know, umpteen times. I didn't get better. So the thing with the Taubman is I immediately got all these tools to use and a different way of using my body. So it was a lot of unlearning. And you know, I have to say, you know, as I said before, I felt like giving up definitely, especially during those 9 months, those first 9 months. But John never gave up on me. I mean, how many times I had the same issue, I would come to him with the same problem. He says, it's fine. Don't worry about it. That's the nature of the process. So it was because I was so respected, you know, in such a humane fashion. And, you know, we all know teachers who are not like that. Unbelievable patience on his part. Unbelievable patience. So, you know, we just kept doing things over and over again. And so there was a point where I was starting to play more advanced repertoire. Got a Chopin Polonaise, Scarlatti Sonata. And this was all, these were all learning opportunities. Each one of these pieces, I would learn more about the Taubman technique and or approach. And there came a time where I said, you know, John would say, what do you want to learn? And I said, well, I don't think I can learn that. It's too difficult. And John would say, yeah, let's do it. So got to the point where actually studied this and learned the Scriabin Sonata, very difficult, number 3.
And wow.
About a year and a half ago, I asked him, you know, I'd love to study Liszt Mephisto Waltz, which was a piece that I never thought I could possibly play in this lifetime. You know, it was just totally beyond me. And, you know, I stuck at it. It was very difficult, but I really got it to a really high level. And, you know, both of us were very pleased with it. So, you know, basically with this approach, the sky's the limit. If you have the basic tools, and then you know, and you have to become a detective. You have to really become independent in a sense. You have to really, you know, a teacher can guide you, of course, but ultimately you have to use the tools and figure out how to use them with your particular makeup, with your mental makeup, the way you process things intellectually, and also with your physical makeup. So you have to use all these tools and discover what's the priority? Is it the rotation? Is it the shaping? Is it the in and out movements? You know, all these different things are, you know, required, but they're different passages have different focuses in terms of these tools as to which tool is going to help you the most or which combination of tools is going to help you the most. So that's really, you know, that's really the learning process. And, you know, I feel right now I'm on a level where it's actually fun. Because,
yeah.
One of the things I've always admired about really great pianists is, you know, they could play the simplest, you know, they could play Mary Had a Little Lamb, but the tone would be so beautiful. And besides giving you a facility, Taubman Approach also gives you a way to create a beautiful sound on the piano by using, yes. You know, the body weight. And that it's so gratifying because my touch has changed. And I go to the piano now, it's like, wow, this is really wonderful. You know,
yeah.
It's a wonderful feeling to be able to go and play this stuff and even play, you know, easier repertoire or repertoire I've studied before or learned when I was a kid, but I can play them so differently now. It's like really revolutionary. It's nothing short of that.
Wow, that is phenomenal, Nathan, to hear you say that as a lifelong educator, to say that the Taubman approach has really ignited in you that educator mind, so to speak, that curious mind to figure out what tools to bring to each passage in pieces that you want to play. And that's got to be just so exciting for you.
Yeah, you know, I mean, there are going to be times when I'll need to go back to John and ask, you know. But I feel, you know, right now I'm in a very, very good place. I'm preparing for a recital. And, you know, it's like, wow, this is what I need to do. And you know, it's really important for me to go through with this process, you know, but it's just,
wow. If you were to share with somebody, or if somebody were to come to you that, you know, maybe just retired and wants to get back into playing the piano and is curious about the Taubman work, what would you say to them? What would you encourage them to do in maybe pursuing the Taubman work? Some guidelines, some kind of words of wisdom. So,
well, you know, certainly go to a workshop, either in person. I know there are some in person workshops being given now, or go on the Zoom. Go on, you know, the summer symposium, I think, is still being, as far as I know, it's still being done on Zoom. It has been since the pandemic, and you can learn so much. The symposiums or any of the workshops, they're very interactive. I would say that's the best way, rather than reading about it, or, you know, I mean, there are some books, but I think the best thing is just to attend a workshop, you know. Because there are lectures, they're interactive, where everybody gets the same passage and everybody gets a chance to try it out. And there's, you know, very supportive, very respectful types of, you know, input given by the faculty. You know, it's not like it's bad and that's wrong and no, you know, it's not, it's none of that. And I think so many people have been, or a lot of people, including myself, have been with teachers who, you know, who are like that. They weren't humanistic in their approach, and they didn't realize that people, maybe some people really have to, you know, struggle. They don't have a natural technique, because I certainly didn't. You know, it wasn't a natural technique. I didn't suddenly know how to play the piano. I mean, you know, I wouldn't have had all these problems if I had. You know, and there definitely are people like that. But for the vast majority of us, you know, the Taubman is the key. And, you know, I think it's almost criminal that so many people learn the piano and or other instruments incorrectly in ways that, you know, promote injury or do not do them justice, you know, because people have, you know, in my case, I knew I was very musical. I also composed, improvised, things like that. So I was, you know, always very musical, but the piano was such a stumbling block in terms of really playing the repertoire that I wanted to. And this Taubman is just, you know, giving me the opportunity to just overcome all those barriers. It's really a life-changing, it's a life-changing thing.
That is so beautifully said. And yes, I mean, dear listener, if you're listening to this podcast and wondering, is there a better way to learn the piano in a supportive community, a community that is empathetic to your situation? Nathan and I both come from that same cloth to say, wow, we didn't have a natural technique, but we found a real joy of learning the piano and a systematic way of learning the piano in the Taubman approach. Mm. And we want to invite you, dear listener, to visit GolandskyInstitute.org for the best quality of teaching, piano teaching for sure, but teaching in the Taubman approach. And Nathan, where can we find more about you, and where can we point our listeners to maybe that recital that's coming up? We'd love to flood the space with your fans.
How do you mean, like a link or a...
Yeah, a link, yeah, social media.
I'd be glad to give that to you. I don't have anything right now, but...
Okay, great. Well, we'll include it.
I appreciate that so much, Benjamin. So, yeah, I'd be very happy to do that.
Yeah, because that would be great. We want to share this in our our show notes on the podcast and any other kind of links to Nathan's work. And how can people, for example, get in touch with you, Nathan?
They can, I can give you my email. That's fine.
Okay. And I'll include that. I'll include that in a...
Oh, okay. Terrific.
Yeah. In a sort of a cryptic way, let's say, so that you don't get all the bots coming after your inbox.
Yes. There are definitely pitfalls to that. Yes. And you'll guide me on that. I hope.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, this has just been such a joy for me. And I know it's going to be just such a wonderful episode for our audience. And is there anything else that you'd like to share about your contact with the Taubman Approach and John Bloomfield? We can never say enough about that man and how many people he's impacted in his humanity and in his teaching. There are no words.
You're absolutely right about that. Absolutely right. I just say, please, go to a workshop, summer symposium, or, just doesn't have to be that, can be just a 2-day, 3-day workshop. And they're given different parts of the country and, just try it out and see what it's about and then go from there because it's so different than how many teachers teach. It's just a wonderful, wonderful thing, There aren't that many things like that in this world that are so life-changing and transformative, and and this is one of them. So I really have to invite everyone, please, if you're interested at all. And Taubman is also being applied to other instruments. I know they have a violin teacher on the faculty. And probably, before long, we'll have many other instruments as well, because it's all about efficiency in movement and choreography. And this can be applied to other skills, other instruments. So it's just incredible. So please, everybody listening to this, please, if you know somebody who's struggling or wants to play better, wants to get more satisfaction out of their playing, doesn't have to be professional, it can just be for their own enjoyment, please tell them about this.
Yes.
All right.
Well, thank you, Nathan, for joining us today on Inside the Taubman Approach.
It's my pleasure, Benjamin. Thank you so much for inviting me and doing this. It's great.